Hello students, welcome back to the online class. We have completed looking at personal pronoun and its types, and also we have learned what is possessive pronouns. And today we will learn about demonstrative pronouns. What is a demonstrative pronoun? Pronouns such as that, this, these, and those used to point to a specific things they refer to are called demonstrative pronouns. So once again I will say, a demonstrative pronoun is a pronoun that is used to point to something specific within a sentence when used to represent a thing or things. Demonstrative pronouns can be either near or far, in distance or time. Near in this time or distance, we use this or these, and far in distance or time, we use that or those. There are only a few demonstrative pronouns in English language. There are just three simple rules for using them correctly. Remember them and you will have no difficulty in using these in your own sentences. The first one is, demonstrative pronouns always identify nouns, whether those nouns are named specifically or not. For example, I can't believe this. Here, we have no idea what this is, but it's definitely something the writer cannot believe. It exists, even though we don't know what it is. And secondly, demonstrative pronouns are usually used to describe animals, places, or thing. However, they can be used to describe people when the person is identified. For example, this sounds like Mary singing. And in the example which is given in your textbook, let us take that. The first example, I like the color of dress. Here, this is used as a demonstrative adjective. Now, what is a demonstrative adjective? A demonstrative adjective is followed by a noun. Now let me look at the sentence. What is the noun here? Dress is noun. So this sentence is demonstrative adjective. The second example. This is the dress that I wish to buy for my birthday. Here, this is used as a demonstrative pronoun. You remember what is demonstrative pronoun? Pronoun that is used in place of a noun. So this, in that example, this sentence is demonstrative pronoun. Replaces a noun. So here, sometimes we are confused with where to use demonstrative adjective and where to use demonstrative pronoun. So the words are identical, but demonstrative adjectives qualify nouns, whereas demonstrative pronoun stands alone. The main thing you have to remember that, children, we use demonstrative pronoun in place of noun, and demonstrative adjective is followed by a noun. Now I will give you the homework, that is, Page number 22. Filling the blanks with either demonstrative pronouns or demonstrative adjective. You have to complete writing it test book. Thank you. Hello students. Today, let us look at what is interrogative pronouns. What is interrogative pronouns? Pronouns such as who, whose, which and what that are used to ask questions are called interrogative pronouns. In other way, we can say an interrogative pronoun is a pronoun which is used to make asking questions easy. There are just 5 interrogative pronouns. Each one is used a very specific questions or indirect questions. Like who and whom refers only to people. Others can be used to refer to objects or people. And what are the 5 interrogative pronouns? That are what, which, who, whom, whose. Let us take the first one, what. What is used to ask questions about people or object. For example, what do you want for dinner? And the second one is which. Which is used to ask questions about people or object. For example, which color do you prefer? And the next one is who is used to ask questions about people. Who is used to ask questions about people? For example, who was driving the car? Now the next one is whom. This interrogative pronoun is rarely seen these days, but when it is shows up, it is used to ask questions about people. For example, whom did you speak to? And the last one is whose. Whose is used to ask questions about people or object, always related to possession. For example, whose sweater is this? Otherwise, we can ask, whose parents are these?